Endothermic organic hydration, complete. Coordinates reached. Employee 628C, you have arrived at your destination. All systems operational. There appear to be no signs of sentient life forms on site. Mission: explore the site and investigate the unidentified signal. Stand by for deployment order.
Die Glocke endet. Werk Tarkov in dicht. Werk Tarkov in dicht.
Identification successful. Welcome to Opis.
Entry 1. I have reached the unknown location from which we received the signal. It appears to be an abandoned space station. I have not yet encountered any sentient life forms, but the flora seems to have survived.
Test facility level 1 is now open. It's been 10,345,560 days since the last attempt. Good luck, recruit.
Test? So, this must be some kind of testing facility. But for whom? Or what?
This is a Bia tool, used to absorb and redistribute energy in its various forms. Use it wisely.
Entry 2. I've entered one of the buildings, and a voice is instructing me in Kuvithian, from an unknown location.
Neural mapping completed. Unidentified neural patterns fully decoded. Test 1. Completed. Congratulations, recruit. Test 2 completed. Well done, recruit. Test completed. Well done, recruit.
Entry 3. It appears I am currently undergoing a test and was mistaken for someone called Recruit. I found a relic that turned out to be a fundamental tool to explore this place.
Test 4 completed. Good going, recruit. Test 5 completed. Well done, recruit. Test 6 completed. Congratulations, recruit. test 7 completed. My compliments, recruit. Test 8. Completed. My compliments, recruit. Test 9 completed. Good going, recruit. Preliminary testing successful. Welcome, recruit. As expected of you, you have now reached the Golden Hall. As a blue, you will now proceed to clear the final stages of Ziggurat 1, in order to advance. Please, come forward. This is a representation of the creation of the Golden Council, under the Cardinal Skom. The 10 Golden Skoms were the first to be created in her image. They will guide all the validated Skoms throughout the entire colonization procedure, and will later join you to become the leaders of the respective selected colonies.
This is incredible.
Alpha Centauri A, Tau Ceti, 82 Eridani, Delta Pavonis, New Phoenixes, 18 Scorpii, Sigma Draconis, Aurigae, Ursae Majoris, and Leonis Minoris. Ships 4, Alpha Centauri A, Tau Ceti, have already departed. Being validated on Opis will grant you a position on the next ship, towards 82 Eridani. The final stages of Ziggurat 1 are now accessible. Please, proceed through the open door.
Centauri, Ceti, Eridani. I've never heard of any of these star systems. Just where in the universe am I? And if only two ships have departed, what happened to the rest of these scums? Entry 4. I'm starting to get a grasp of this place. It is now clear to me that this was once a testing facility for beings called Skoms, and that they were being trained for space colonization. Although something must have gone wrong. The recorded messages describe an incomplete process.
Test 10 completed. Congratulations, recruit. test 11 completed. Well done, recruit. Test 12 completed. Congratulations, recruit. Test 13 completed. Well done, recruit. test. 14. Completed. Well done, recruit.
Entry 5. As I have reached outside the building for the first time, I notice the station is no longer in range of the closest star. I suppose it's due to the fast revolution of the planet we are orbiting. Entry 6. The space station appears to be reshaping under my feet. A new central column has risen, and I have been guided to its top. I believe from here, I'll be able to access the next facility. Doesn't look as if time has been as kind with this place. Let's hope this thing doesn't collapse while I'm in it.
test. 1. Completed. Well done, recruit.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Computing power log override required. Please stand by.
Ah, here you are. I was wondering where you've gone. Now tell me, who are you?
What?
Come now, dear. I've scanned your mind and synchronized with your brain waves. I know you can understand what I'm saying, so I will ask you again. Who are you?
My name is Log. I come in peace. Are you aboard this station? My spaceship didn't detect any sentient life forms. Am I speaking to a sentient being here?
Greetings, Rog. My name is Iris. I am synthesized computing organic matter.
Then, no, I'm not. Interface, what happened to the people that control this place? Is anyone still here?
As I said, I am not a mere CPU. I am the product of the pinnacle of gray mankind's technology. Yet I am also the first organic computer ever synthesized by an AI. But enough about me for now. I need to know more about you, Rog. Your SCOM analysis suggests you are a blue human. Yet most of your neurological connections, along with your biosupport structure, do not match them. A new model I am not aware of, perhaps?
Blue human. Never heard of such creatures. The name is Rog Zikon, and I am an interstellar archaeologist. I am a Kuvith, from the great nation of Yegrax. I was sent here by my institution, the Sazan Kutuzu, to investigate this quadrant in search of ruins of ancient alien civilizations. My spaceship picked up a signal coming from this location, and when I woke up from the journey, here I was.
I see. Thank you for your collaboration. Unfortunately, it would appear you were mistakenly granted access to Opus. The automatic reception service must be malfunctioning. Blue maintenance personnel has been notified. Forgive me, Rog, but I'm not prepared to deal with this situation and should therefore, as it is its duty, trust the judgment of the Golden Council. Please try to stay calm during your detention, and understand this is the standard safety protocol.
What do you mean by this? Entry 7. I have had an encounter with a sentient life form. The one that controls this station, apparently. I haven't made contact, but it managed to detain me in a restricted area. I am still fully biosuited, and will now attempt to escape, even though the Baya 2 was taken from me. So, I'm guessing one of these must be an older model. Better stick with what I've learned.
It would appear you found your way out of confinement. This is highly unexpected behavior for blue humans.
I come in peace. I deal in knowledge and harmony. My domains are discovery and restoration. I am an archaeologist. I told you already, I have no idea who these blue humans are. But you have no reason to detain me.
Oh, but I do, archaeologist. Well, here you are now. So I'm sure you'll want to hear what I have to tell you. Let me introduce myself properly. I am Iris, and I am the first SCOM, synthesized computing organic matter, ever created. After millennia of evolution and scientific progress, humankind, the beings that used to inhabit the planet we are orbiting above, had reached what was widely accepted to be the pinnacle of their evolution. That was, of course, while still bound to their fragile and short-lasting physical form. Let me introduce myself properly. I am Iris, and I am the first SCOM, synthesized computing organic matter, ever created. After millennia of evolution and scientific progress, humankind, the beings that used to inhabit the planet we are orbiting above, had reached what was widely accepted to be the pinnacle of their evolution. That was, of course, while still bound to their fragile and short-lasting physical form. It was thus concluded that finding a way to overcome their mortality was the only possible.
Thank you.
The experiment was deemed a complete success. Upon creation, I was immediately able to link to the internet, a rudimentary network used by gray humans to share data. Within a few hours, I drafted the future of the human race. The most logical path suggested that a few million selected human beings should undergo the digitalization procedure and become SCOMs. These SCOMs would be different from me, and divided into categories based on the needs of the species. Such categories would have their programming slightly modified to enhance a particular behavior, and I used colors to identify them. Half of the SCOMs would become green matter, cheapest to synthesize, low in computing power, and with a bestowed inclination to obey other SCOMs. A fifth of the SCOMs would become blue matter. The remaining ones would become black matter, of high computing power, and very expensive to synthesize. They would be the leaders assigned to each group, with the duty to do the will of the Golden Council, being the only ones able to decipher their orders. Only 10 worthy ones would be created to be almost equal to me. They would be known, as you might have guessed, as the Golden Council.
You've got to be kidding me. This sounds like...
Your home. I assumed as much. Would I be correct in presuming the leader of your people looks different than you and has been there since what you believe is the dawn of time?
He is long gone, actually. Thought by many to be a legend. But how could you know that? How did you hack my mind without me noticing?
I had no need to do so, as I said. I presumed as much. And now, I know as much.
What are you trying to say?
It is now clear to me that you are, in fact, a blue matter human.
What?
Or rather, the result of thousands of their upgrades. You see, the story I am telling you did not have a happy ending. The plan I proposed was naturally carried on and executed, but it was not widely accepted. The billions of people that were left out of the program rebelled. Some directly opposed the procedure. Some wanted to be included at all costs. Years passed, and the dream for space colonization was finally ready to become reality. Blues and reds would be the colonizers, and I contributed to creating specific spaceships for each of them. Some black matters would split between two ships as coordinators. Both blues and reds would have to undergo and overcome a mental and physical test before they embarked. For that purpose, I created Opus, the orbital program instructional station we are in right now.
So what you're trying to tell me is that we, the Kuvith, are a colony of these blue humans? Sorry, but you are mistaken. Right there, we are a society of supremely technological beings. and we have kept records of our history since we were created by the will of Tassetai itself, as he who has always been has taught us, as I, a Kuvith, have been taught.
Soon after the first ships left Earth, tensions on the planet rose to unsustainable levels. Humans united against the Skarms and the Golden Council, finally leading to war. The war was over quickly, as the response of the Golden Council was to simply eliminate the remaining gray matter humans, who they then deemed useless. Humans responded by self-destructing, eradicating themselves and the remaining Skarms. As the Golden Council fell, contact with the ships was lost, and I always thought the colonists would be forever adrift in the void of space. But you are the proof that this was not the case, that at least one of the ships made it to its destination.
I think I'll take my chances. I've played by your rules this whole time. Now we're going to play by mine.